Hi, I'm Stephen Shiflett, and for our intercultural oral history assignment, I had the privilege to interview my grandfather. His name is Nelson Carbonell. He was born on March 5th, 1940 in Cuba. So a few things about his story. My grandmother also grew up in Cuba, and during the Cuban Revolution in 1959, my grandmother, because she was an upper-class citizen from a wealthy family, was able to escape immediately and immigrate to the US before 1960. As for my grandfather, he wasn't so lucky. He had a lot more disadvantages in his life and his upbringing, as his family struggled on the line of poverty for his entire upbringing. He lived in a poor town with hardly any food on the table. And so when he was 19 years old, he was drafted into the war in Cuba to fight against Fidel Castro and his men. To skip a lot of very crucial details that he gave to me, which was just an honor to be able to sit there and talk with him one-on-one. Even though I've heard so many stories and bits and pieces, it was nice to be able to put it all together and just hear from him, you know, one-on-one in a situation like that. But anyway, he was captured by Fidel Castro and his men when my grandfather, along with maybe 100 other soldiers, were waiting on a beach for the United States infantry to come and rescue them. So due to the US not showing up, my grandfather was left behind and was captured and was a prisoner of war for over 2 years in Cuba. But eventually he was lucky enough to escape and make it to the US and reunite with my grandmother. And from that, they had 7 children and now 30 grandchildren and a few great grandchildren, with many more on the way. So it's just really amazing to be able to sit back and look at that legacy that he was able to get out. Just one person had an effect that great, that so much life came from it. And it's just truly a miracle.
And I believe that a huge power dynamic we see, and that I got from this interview, is the difference between my grandma and my grandpa. As my grandmother was a wealthy citizen who was able to get out right away, and my grandfather wasn't. I think something new that I learned is that culture is heavily influenced by power. And we think about the culture that my grandpa came into in the US at 22 years old, and he spent the past 60 years here. And his culture has definitely shifted a little. And lastly, something that came to mind while interviewing him, keeping in mind the idea of how can we illuminate these aspects of culture and of power that we don't see so easily, and the ones that aren't so obvious. I read that 90% of culture is hidden elements and hidden things that, you know, we don't know. And I think the only way truly to illuminate these aspects is by asking people to tell their stories, and by hearing people and accepting people. Communicating with one another is the only way that we can get through to one another and change these power dynamics and the way that we value and perceive culture. So I believe hearing from people like my grandfather and what he went through, there's millions of people like him that have quite an amazing story, maybe even more. And I think the only way that we can bring these aspects to light is by hearing these people's stories and their testimonies.